This is Phil DeBella, and you're listening to FlashCast by PDB. Today, I want to explore the topic of goal setting. What a way to do it, the start of 2019. We'll actually purposely left it a month because to show quickly how a year will disappear. So this will now be playing in February, and the first month of the year is already gone, and gives it even more meaning of why we should be planning and making sure that we outline what our vision is for 2019 and what we want to achieve. So I want to just share how I go about the process. So at the end of every year, I reflect back, obviously, as I do monthly, but at the end of the year, I reflect back and have a look at what I've achieved and what I haven't achieved and cross the things off that I have as I've done it, and then explore the whys and why I haven't been able to achieve certain things. But I outline my goals in simple: professional, personal, and family. And what I do is I outline between 4 and 6 items in each one that I really want to achieve. So high-level things that mean something to me. Now, high-level means what it means to you. Remember, goals are personal. They're all about you. This is the one time that we need to look insular and look at ourselves and really understand what it is that will define us. And what I mean by that is things like our purpose, our why. You know, our goals are the what we do. It's how we go about defining the why in ourselves. So we need to understand, firstly, why we set goals. We set goals because they are the way that enables us to fulfill our purpose, to make us feel validated, to make us feel we have a purpose, that we are doing something of great value that emotionally engages us with this world. And that is the purpose of goal setting. The areas of goals is obviously there's three. There's professional goals, there's personal goals, and there's family goals. Professional, and this is a system I use even with my children. It doesn't matter what age they are. Professional will obviously mean schooling, will mean education, will mean whatever it is, depending on the age that they are. But obviously for myself, the professional goals are across investments, across work, what I do day to day. And I've outlined this year 5 goals that I want to achieve across, you know, certain businesses, from New York to obviously international copy traders to, you know, being back in the chair role at DeBella Coffee. So professional goals that I want to achieve. And what I do also is I put a little bit of a catchphrase of what I want to become, a bit of a title. So, you know, some people have used superheroes, some people, but it's about the imagination. It's about letting your mind run wild. Now, for me, it's about a title. You know, I use statements. So for professional goals, I set certain statements that really, you know, create an emotional engagement. And I suppose that, to me, is all about brand. If I emotionally connect with it, then I'm branding myself professionally. I mean, you can use whatever manner suits yourself, but the most important thing is to understand why you set goals, and the next thing is to understand that you need to separate them into 3 areas. Then I've got professional goals, and under professional goals, I've got 6 goals this year, some around my weight, some around bucket list items, some as simple as being able to do 5 chin-ups. I've never been able to do a chin-up. Recently, I've been able to now do 1.5. So the goal by the end of this year is to do 5 or more chin-ups. Things like play more tennis, compete in another boxing fight. So these are things that I've set myself this year under personal goals. And again, I've created a bit of a statement. Here in personal, the statement, the brand this year is that I want to live a life of harmony, being the best that I can be. And that brand statement, as I meant before, emotionally engages me with my goals. But you can use whatever you like. Some might draw it in a picture, some might use super, you know, characters, whatever it is that engages you with the goals that you've set. And then finally, family. And in no particular order, it's not that family comes last, I've just done it in that order. You know, family is things around date nights and more activity with kids, you know, and then down to specific things with family that I want to help them achieve that enables me to feel that I have a strong purpose. Remember, your goals are yours. I keep coming back to that. The goals are yours. They are things that enable you to ground yourself with the world, that makes you feel purposeful, that makes you feel complete, that emotionally engages you with what it is that you stand for and who you are. The goals are the one area that we can afford to be selfish. They are not goals for other people, unless, of course, part of achieving that goal and feeling centered is around helping somebody else. So, you know, and my brand statement around family is to create thousands of magic moments with my family and friends. To me, that's something I talk about. Life's measured in moments, it's not measured in possessions. So therefore, to me, the brand statement, the catchphrase that emotionally engages me with the goals in family is to make sure that I'm creating thousands of magic moments and memorable moments with family and friends. And as I said, as we kick off 2019, you'll see that it flies. You know, January's already gone. And that is why I wanted to share this whole flashcast around goal setting and how I go about it and why I go about it. It is important. The purpose behind it is to make sure that you are living a full life, a life that you feel that you are connected with, a life that you feel that you have purpose for. And again, that is something that is entirely personal. I come across many people talking about goal setting and ticking boxes, and they go about the motions, but they're not actually understanding what or why they're doing it. And it is so important that we understand why we go about doing things. And of course, this flashcast is about goals, but the theory that I talk about stem across many different areas in life. And again, the purpose of these flashcasts is to have those short, sharp, under 10-minute discussions around certain topics that mean something to me and how I go about doing things. I get a lot of requests for mentoring and catch-ups, and unfortunately, I can't catch up or mentor everybody. So doing the flashcast by PDB is one way that enables me to have a wider reach and hopefully help people become the best that they can be. To me, a full life is all about being the best that you can be, understanding that we're on this constant journey towards betterment, and that it's sometimes we're going to plateau. And plateauing is all part of the ride. Plateauing is part of the journey. Just make sure that you don't get stuck in plateau mode. And that's something else that comes up a lot. And another good reason why you should be setting really clear goals or vision statements or vision plans or whatever you want to call them, vision boards. There's many different words. The bottom line is that you are outlining something that you want to travel towards. You're outlining a destination that you are traveling towards. And of course, the most important part is to enjoy the journey. That once you reach that destination, it's time to then push yourself to that next destination. And of course, remember that success is measured by yourself. How you deem yourself to feel and how you deem yourself to be and who you are is about you. It's about your interpretation of oneself. It's not about somebody else's interpretation of yourself. Of course, we all get bogged down at times and we get affected by what people say and what they think. And that's, again, part of the journey. That's part of that whole betterment. That's part of that plateauing. It's going to happen. It's going to. But however, that mindset's got to kick in and you've got to get back into that comfort zone of mindset. You've got to get that strong mindset and believe in yourself. You know, we come alone, we go alone. It doesn't mean we have to have a lonely life, but remember that it is you that makes the difference. The common denominator between success and failure is you. And part of that is mindset. You've got to choose the right mindset. And of course, by applying goals, by understanding your why, your purpose, understanding what your life is all about, and then obviously having that sense of achievement and reflecting back on what you're doing and how you're going and how you're progressing will help you feel connected. It'll feel you, help you feel emotionally balanced. Setting goals in those three areas of your life will hopefully help you achieve harmony. Remember, harmonious life is what we're all chasing, something that enables us to feel great about what we do, who we are, and why we are here. Guys, thank you. Make 2019 your best year yet. And remember that life's about a journey. Be the best you can be. You've been listening to Philip DiBella, and this is Flashcast by PDB.